100th day press conference held at the presidential office is where we begin this afternoon. President Moon's remarks, especially those made during an unscripted Q&A session, are already making headlines across the globe. And without further ado, let's connect to our Blue House correspondent Hwang Ho-jun for more on the details. So, Ho-jun, quite a few solid statements he made today.
Down, you're absolutely right. More than 250 reporters from Korea and abroad attended the press conference today. And it was the first of its kind with no prepared set of questions to rehearse, but a spontaneous Q&A session between the president and the media. Now, the highlight of the afternoon was when the president mentioned that North Korea is nearing the so-called red line, which will lead him to shift away from his policy of engagement with Pyongyang.
Missile을 완성하고 거기에 핵탄두를 탑재해서 무기화하게 되는 것을 레드라인이라고 생각합니다.
Now, as you can imagine, questions regarding the escalating tensions in the region due to belligerent rhetoric between the U.S. and North Korea were inevitable. To refresh your memory, that rhetoric includes North Korea claiming it was devising a planned strike near the U.S. territory of Guam with four of its missiles, and Trump in return saying North Korea will experience, quote, fire and fury if it attacks, and that the U.S. is, quote, locked and loaded in case North Korea acts unwisely. Emphasizing Seoul is the one that is most directly affected by North Korea's nuclear and missile issues, President Moon sternly said any sort of military action requires South Korea's consent and underscored that another war on the peninsula is absolutely out of the question. He insisted that Washington and Seoul are fundamentally on the same page in putting pressure and sanctions on Pyongyang to denuclearize the regime and bring it back to the negotiation table. President Moon even said he'll consider sending a special envoy to North Korea if the North stops its provocations. On domestic issues, President Moon said that he will keep his promise to revise the Constitution by the local elections next year, actually say to take place in June next year, to be more exact, to strengthen regional autonomy and the fundamental rights of the people. He also stressed the government will do its best to eliminate abuse of privilege, foul play, and corruption, and will strive to rebuild a fair and righteous Korea. Back to you, Dan.
Our Hwang Ho-jun at the presidential office for us. Thank you.